This video shows how to perform instance segmentation in the deep learning software Mech-DLK. The instance segmentation module helps solve problems like, where is it? What is it? What is it like? The module can locate, segment, and classify individual objects in the images. In this video, the objects are metal workpieces. The instance segmentation module aids the vision processing algorithms in producing accurate vision results when workpieces are dispersed, disordered, stacked, or located close to one another. Preparing a trained instance segmentation model involves importing training images into Mech-DLK, labeling the images, training the model, and validating the model. After validation, export the model, and then import it into the machine vision software Mech-Vision to use it for vision processing. Now let's take a look at the actual operational steps. Open Mech-DLK, create a new project, name the project Metal Workpiece, and save the project to an empty folder. After creating the new Mech-DLK project, follow the instructions in the software to add the instance segmentation module. Import the selected images and adjust the quantity ratio of images in the training set to the validation set to 8:2. Use the ROI tool to select the region of interest, thereby removing irrelevant backgrounds while covering where the workpieces will be present. Reserve some additional buffer space in the ROI. Click Apply to apply the ROI to all images. Next, we need to label the images. Accurate labeling is crucial for the model's effectiveness. Please avoid incomplete or incorrect labeling. We also need to customize labeling rules for on-site applications. In the example of this video, the deep learning model needs to recognize fully exposed top-layer metal workpieces, so we should only label all the completely exposed workpieces on the top layer. Now that we know the requirements, let's begin labeling. We can use the polygon tool to label images. The tool accurately marks the workpiece contours by tracing vertices and connecting them together. Let's create a new label and name it Metal Workpiece. Left-click on the label edges to add vertices. The polygon tool needs a minimum of 3 vertices to create a closed pattern. Right-click to confirm the labeling. Ensure accurate labeling with vertices close to the workpiece contours. Do not omit any workpieces that are fully exposed and on the top layer. Maintain consistency in the labeling process by following a standardized labeling specification. For example, if we decide to label only fully exposed top layer metal workpieces, it is essential to ensure that we label only those in the images. Labeling consistency is guaranteed as long as the images are labeled according to the agreed specifications. After labeling all the images, we can start training. Before training, click Training Parameter Settings to look up the training parameters. The setting of training parameters will directly affect the training speed and accuracy of the model, and the default parameter setting can already meet most circumstances. So let's first look at the training parameters that need to be adjusted for this training. The first is model type, which includes light and normal. The light model performs better with CPU deployment. It is applied to simple application scenarios, such as carton depalletizing scenarios with relatively low accuracy requirements. The normal model performs better with GPU deployment. It is applied to complex application scenarios, such as picking random and unorderly stacked metal workpieces. In this video, we chose a normal model. The next thing to adjust is the epochs. As the epochs increase, the accuracy of training results will converge to a certain value. Adjust the epochs accordingly to effectively avoid insufficient or excessive model training. After parameter configuration, click Train and the current project will join the training queue. We can find the current training queue and the training time in the Training Center. After the training is completed, we can import some images not involved in training into the Mech-DLK project. Set these images as the test set, and click Validate to validate the model to see how well the trained model can be applied to the current project. Click Export, set the parameters of the model to be exported in the pop-up window, and then click Export and select a directory to save the exported model. Now we have completed the training of the instance segmentation model. Open the Mech-Vision project. Find Step Deep Learning Model Package Inference in the Step Library. Find Model Package Management Tool and import the model we just exported from Mech-DLK. Running this step, we can find that the instance segmentation has segmented individual metal workpieces and obtained a pixel-wise mask of each workpiece. We can use step apply masks to point clouds to extract point clouds for individual workpieces, and using those point clouds for individual 3D matching for the metal workpieces can effectively improve the stability of matching. Eventually, the poses exported here will be included in the vision result. In this video, no further pose processing is required. In some other scenarios, the poses calculated from 3D matching will go through adjustment, offsetting, etc. before output.